Hello friends, this is Shruti Mohide from Papers and Scissors. So as the Valentine's Day is coming up, people are searching for many ideas of what to be a Valentine. So this is a handmade gift which you can give your Valentine. So I've used a matchbox. This is a matchbox. I've opened this from here so that I can paint from inside. I've already done the painting on the outside. This is the chalk paint. You can use any chalk paint. I used iCraft chalk paint because I wanted the red color. I have this in red, and I have used Kraft Angles white chalk paint to paint the draw. Okay, I've already painted this, and here I'm going to paint the inner portion. Just apply two coats and leave this to dry. So once this is done, we'll move on to the next step. Okay, after this dries up, I'll apply the second coat and get back to you. So once the color is dried up, what I'm going to do is I'm going to turn the box over. The print which was there on the top, I'll be putting that side inside. So just fold it the other way so that the box looks very neat and clean. Take glue and just take this. I've got a big duplicate. Just place it. Let this stick. By the time we'll make the drawer ready. For this, I'm going to deco bunch. I've taken this roses tissue. Since I'm going to place some roses inside, we'll be doing some deco bunch work. So the side which I've used. Just take brush, dip it in water, separate the tissue with it. Remove all the sharp edges on the stone, the tearing effect, sharp edges. See, there are plies behind this. We are taking only the top portion. There are two extra plies which I'll remove and keep aside. Now place this inside the box. This is a big design, so this will cover the drawer properly. Now, I'm going to take more watch and very little. Just spread whatever mouthwash you've taken, but take very little of mouthwash. And now, fingers should be dry. They should not have any water, glue, or anything, or else the tissue may tear. Let this dry. We'll apply one more coat. Drop also, if in case the tissue is not stuck anywhere. So in this way, we take small small pieces and cover the drawer everywhere with the tissue. So since this piece is not going to be used, tear this. Now see, you can place it this way so that there is a straight line coming on this edge. Okay, you can put it inside also. You just remove the extra ply. Always check that the two plies have come off. If you want, you can place it inside also. This looks better. So, this week, just go on covering the entire drawer. It will very very tiny prints can be used. this way. Have to complete that. So I've taken a thin strip of cardstock, or you can take card paper. This is 4 centimeters, and what I've done is at 0.5 centimeters, I've folded this inside, then outside, inside, outside on both the sides. Okay, you'll get in handle. I don't know whether I'll be placing this or not, but I'm keeping this ready. And again, I'm going to put a print over this. I've not applied any gesso or anything on this. I'm directly going to stick. This tissue, just remove the ply behind this. There are a lot of craft stores selling these decoupage tissues, so you can just get decoupage tissues. And I'll be cutting the extra. No need for the tissue behind this. Just fold it inside. This tissue dry. So now I've taken these small roses. These are ready-made roses. Not made them. These are mulberry flowers, and you can order them from Crafters Corner. This is Delhi Crafters Corner. In. I've taken some pollens, red and white. Since this is a Valentine theme, I've taken only red and white color. This is to be tied with the thread. With normal thread. So we'll just rotate this thread and tie a knot. See, just make a twist this and put it around the bunch and just pull this so that there is a knot. Now cut the thread and this is a lace I have got. Either put it this way post I'll cover this with green tape. Just apply Fevicol. On the thread. Start folding this. This bouquet looks good. So I've decided to wrap this golden ribbon I have got. Light blue, just roll this again. I want to place a note inside this. So I have written this quote on a plain paper. You can check for notes on Pinterest. You can take down some notes and write it in your own writing. And this is gathered twigs distressing. And I have taken an applicator and I am distressing the edges. Give it a old age look. What I'm going to do is taken a little bit of coffee in this, a pinch of coffee, and added water to this. Just going to make this paper a little bit vintagey. See that the pen you are using is waterproof. I've used archival ink pen. This is an archival ink pen. This is Micron 01 pen. This is waterproof so that the ink won't bleed. Okay. Just adding here and there. I'll leave this to dry, because then we are going to roll this and put it in the drawer. Let this dry. And before we start placing everything inside, de-stress the box, the brown color. I will take a much darker color. This is one with stain. When you are going to decobodge the drawer inside, it is going to be thicker than that it was earlier. So you just have to check it before you stick this outer box, because it won't fit in as it has become a bit thicker. So just place it inside and then stick this sides. Yeah, done with the deep dressing part. Now, before that, I want to show you something. If this fits in, then only we'll do this. I have got. This is I love you written on this cardstock. I've got a die cut of this. It just wrote I love you in the center. You can just cut a square or a rectangle into the size you want. And distance is a bit deeper also. For space there. Yeah. And now this is a cardstock. This you can just place this over this and take 1 centimeter extra, and this is 0.5 centimeter. And now I'm going to fold these in this on the lines. Okay, it will be this way. It is an envelope, and I'm going to cut this. From both sides, 0.5 centimeter. I'm going to fold. Now I have to cut this. This will easily fit inside this. I'm going to close this. You can use a toothpick because it's a smaller area. Now this. I've taken a rose from the tissue we used. I'm going to stick this as a stamp over here. And I've written over here, this is urgent. And this is for the top of the box. And this we need to distress. You can also do it with red color. Since the background is they have taken down. Someone place on the top of the box. Now, this is the message which is urgent. Urgent, I love you. So this will be going inside this window. Now I've got this postal stamp set. Stamp something on this. That kind of thing. The top decoration for this, I've taken a cardstock and written Happy Valentine's Day. This I'm going to place on the top. For this, I've taken double sided tape. Safe on side, like Fevicol. Please, sir. And think only one layer will be okay because it has become too raised. Decoration part. Just try for some time. And now, this paper which we are going to place in it, we have to make small roll. Make it tight. That should take less space. Now, I'm going to tie this ribbon around it. Replacing this small angle. Then this letter angle. This is all that will be going inside. Then we can close this. Before that, we do the decoration part. Taken some flowers. We have white and red flowers. We'll trim the stem. That and this needs to be dried because it will keep moving. So for sticking the flowers, I've taken the silicone glue from Exhibit 6. You can use a hot glue gun also. You can also use Fevicol. Mix with that too. No worries. born arranging the flowers and pollens you have. So I placed pink flowers instead of that red rose because it was not showing up that much. I had this art printed papers with me since many years. So what I'm going to do is the sides. I want to stick this. Okay, because it was looking very blank. So it will be little bit smaller than the sides. Red color should be seen a little bit. Is it? Other side, as I told you, in trying to pull the drawer out, it was getting stuck inside. So I, here you can see that this is a bit broader because I adjusted it according to the drawer. Okay, this is exactly according to the size. The width and trim it. One more small piece I've taken. This is to lock the back of the envelope. Just on the edge, fill of blue and place it behind. The envelope so that it doesn't keep it in. Let it stick in action. by the time it gets trapped by this place, all the things inside. First is the envelope, then is the note, and finally the class. All this will be going. You can also open a matchbox and take the size and make it with a new card paper, because this has become a bit smaller, so it's getting stuck inside. After doing it for several times, it will become broader. So this is what you have kept inside. This is the note. This looks so tiny, but it has taken so much of time. That will be very precious.